Do you have strong views about alien species? Things like obviously mink and signal crayfish and Japanese knotweed and all these horrors. You must come across that quite a lot on the side of the river.
Yeah. I mean, one of the troubles with freshwater invasives is once they're established, they're incredibly difficult to remove. You know, let's say it's something like I'm trying to think of a topside non-native. What were those? A koi pew. So I don't know if, can you remember koi pew?
They were
successfully eradicated, but they were like a kind of small beaver. I think they were South American species, but we eventually got rid of those because they're big. They're kind of easier to spot. But when you think of something like a signal crayfish, which can have thousands and thousands of offspring, and they're all minuscule when they're born, even if you get rid of all the adults, they're just going to come through shortly after. And some of the rivers near me, they pull out tons, literally tons of crayfish in traps, and it doesn't even make a dent half the time in the population. So I think it's choosing your battles wisely. And also weighing up, okay, what is the ecological damage of these things doing? So something like mink, for example, I think with a targeted effort, we could eradicate mink. But it's like, if you've got one river system where they are being removed, but then another one where no one's doing anything, it's almost pointless because they're just going to spread out again. But if there was a targeted effort, then you could get rid of something like that. But the plants and the invertebrates, they're the really tricky ones to get rid of. So I'd obviously rather them not be here. It would be better if they weren't here. But at the end of the day, you have to think, what's the cost of removing them as opposed to maybe something else that's worth more while? So it's a tricky one. Yeah, it'd be better if they weren't here, but it's difficult to remove a lot of these guys.